Today we're looking at this Elemento range of outdoor switches and sockets from Hamilton.
Outdoor sockets from Hamilton?
Yeah, we don't normally assume Hamilton make outdoor switches and sockets. We are sort of used to, when we think of Hamilton, think of high-end decorative accessories, and we've looked at a lot of them on the channel before. But we were recently down at the project in Wales and we spotted an electrician fitting this range of Elemento switches and sockets.
Yeah, when I nipped out to him, the thing that grabbed me straight away was the enclosure and the socket outlet were separate. So when I was investigating it, it's actually you can buy just the enclosure on its own and fit almost whatever you like within that enclosure. They do come standard and I've got some standard arrangements in front of me. So should we take a look at those?
Yeah, have a little closer look. So you can see you can buy them as you'd expect as a socket, and we've got unswitched and switched versions here. You've got a fuse spur, but when you actually buy them, yeah, you've got the socket as a loose item. You fit the back box, and let's have a little closer look at the back box. So we've got our mounting holes here. So different manufacturers have different ways of doing this. Some have the fixing screw hidden in the same pillar that has the gasket in. It's slightly different in this one. You fix through the back, and then you fit the sealing cap when you're finished. Yeah, so you just get the fixing cap there.
You've got to fix quite snugly.
Yeah, and that gives you your IP66 rating. So we've got the gasket on the outside there, and then we've got the front that we fit, and obviously you've got a nice gasket around there, and these sort of gel seals that seal around any cables that you bring in that we're used to seeing on these. But yeah, you're right. So you can either buy them like this with the your chosen wire and accessory in, or you can just buy the empty enclosure. And that got you thinking, Gary.
Got me very excited. I started off by trying to fit one of their high-end socket outlets in there. That don't quite fit. But the thinking behind it was maybe you want some USB outlets outside. We know we're spending more and more time at home, working from home, and enjoying our garden. And that made me think about that metal clad one we'd already reviewed on the channel. It's just down there. Let's see what that one looks like inside. It looks good.
All right, so you're going to put this, a metal clad, yeah. Well, yeah, you've got a metal clad USB outlet.
Grey's on trend as well, grey on grey there. And we've got the ability then to use the USBs because we can just buy the enclosure.
Yeah, and that is probably one of the best benefits of this range, the fact you can do that. Yeah, who knows what you might want to put out there. Yeah, so the USBs, you obviously probably even grid switches in there.
Oh, right, okay, we get grid switches. And again, you imagine you've got a fuse connection unit out there feeding the pond, you have some smaller people join you in your life, and all of a sudden the pond's not acceptable. You get rid of the pond, you can just change that, take the fuse connection unit out, and install a single socket.
Yeah, it also means, obviously, if you've damaged the socket outlet, so people either sometimes leave the cover open, although it's an IP66 socket, they don't latch it fully closed. And obviously, over time, sockets get damaged. Yeah, you just have to change the actual wire and accessory.
Yeah.
You don't have to change the whole enclosure, which is if it's got armoured cables in.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that could be an effort. Now, when thinking about that enclosure, okay, and obviously holding the cover open or shut, you can actually lock it, which is also really good. Shall we have a look at the locking feature?
Yeah, so if I take this one here built up, so I'll notice there is screw caps in there. Obviously, people have a thing on screw caps, but here's the one that's fully assembled with the screw caps. Yeah, if you want to lock this shut.
Yeah, so if it's on the side of your house or the front of your house, and obviously you've gone away, you've got the ability to lock it so nobody could come along and start plugging stuff in. But it got me thinking about when my son was a little bit younger and we'd be off to those parties where we'd have a bouncy castle, mm-hmm. you know, and it's plugged in. Occasionally, my son would drift round to the back of the bouncy castle and operate the switch because it would go down. Well, you could actually lock it on and close, couldn't you, with this range?
Oh, yeah, that's a bit of devilment there. Yeah, okay.
I wonder where he got that from.
Yeah, I wonder. Yeah, and you're right, and again, you probably want to do that on a fuse spur as well. So it's the same on the single gang enclosures. If this was feeding, say, the vending machine, you might just want to put the lock in there. Or it's, again, yeah, just nicely. That's quite a good feature.
Yeah, just being able to lock it on or off. Yeah,
yeah,
that is good.
And then while we're in there, we did touch on armoured cables. The cable entries in the product, obviously lots of them.
There is
lots. We've got double on the bottom there, and there's three on the dual gang box, but they just pop out from the inside out. So you would struggle to get them. You can't get them out this side.
Okay,
so you just pop them out the back. So they're pretty. And then there's the option to drill out an entry in the back, which obviously a lot of people will be doing if they're coming a cable coming out the wall into the back of the unit.
And then we go on and look at switches. So we've got those switches, and then you end up having a little neon on there, and you've come up with an ingenious way of using that switch. So it's dark outside, you've got to look for the switch, it's got a neon on it, but you can get the neon to come on when the light is off. Is that right?
Yeah, on the neon indicator. It's not my genius. It's been, obviously, we've been, lots of manufacturers used to do this on, used to be able to buy indoor light switches with a neon indicator option, but it seems to, people seem to have forgotten about it. And then I thought, well, that was fine with incandescent lamps. I've done an LS lousy.
Let's have a look at this then. He's on with his LS lousy.
So well, here's our neon indicator. So okay. You can see I've got it connected to this sort of vapor-proof baton here.
Okay, so I'd be able to see that potentially if it was outside and it was dark. This was garden lighting or something like that, or maybe in that sort
you're in a warehouse or something. Okay. Where's the light switch? So the neon indicator's on, and then the light comes on, the indicator goes off.
Oh, right, okay.
So it is pre-wired for that in this outdoor range. So we've got single and dual. You can also get retractive switches as well. Just look at the circuit behind that for the people who want the myth and magic behind it. It's obviously got our line conductor in there. We've got the neon indicator wired across the terminals of the switches. And then obviously that's then in series with our lamp. So when the switch is off, obviously the neutral makes its way through the filament of the lamp and then down to the switch. And then when you put the switch on, you're just shorting out the neon indicator, so it no longer glows.
When you say filament, we're now probably talking neon, are we?
Yes. LED lighting, we've gone all LED. You can't get filaments anymore, but it does work with, as you've seen here, this is a vapor-proof baton. That's probably a nice application for this. On the switches, while we're just looking at the switches, Gary, they do tie them up, and obviously it's always a divisive option. You can put the little caps on as well when you're finished.
So I think there's a little groove, isn't there, to help you get them out, isn't
there? There is, yeah. So obviously you can follow our little blue tack trick as well. You can, obviously people always, how do you get them out again? But again, good to stop tampering and things like that, so. I'm messing around with that.
You'll get it in eventually. It's getting them out. They tend to be the issue, but they've got that little groove there, and obviously you get a tiny little screwdriver in to pop them out, and we've done that, haven't we?
Yeah, so these are very tactile, a good feel to those switches. One more thing. There's also a junction box, which I think is a great addition to the range.
Right.
Because you'll know my thoughts on the, whenever I choose an enclosure,
you always choose one too small.
Yeah, one too small. So I thought, let's have a look at this. We've recently been doing some other videos on outdoor LED strip, so watch out for them coming up. But I managed to put the enclosure here. I haven't put the screw caps on yet. So in there, I've managed to fit a small LED driver, an N-Ocean switch, managed to fit the wiring in there and still some gland room. It's cosy.
Yep, it is.
But sometimes, I like this front, the flat front plate there. I could see people possibly putting mini photocells in there or things like that. So it just gives you a few options when it comes to outdoor lighting control. Obviously, people will have seen the video we made on the Hamilton Air outdoor lighting control system, which is obviously a remote control system. But if that doesn't suit the application you're in, I think this enclosure could be good for a lot of things in garden lighting particularly, and obviously very easy to install because it's got the same pop-outs. Very quick.
Which we really did like. I mean, the amount of times you've gone in there and you start drilling can be a little bit of an issue when you're trying drilling holes out on the side surfaces. I think good range.
Yeah, it is a good range.
And we've played around. We even got our red, didn't we, fire fuse connection unit. We fitted that in them and all sorts of things. You can have some fun fitting different accessories in there to match the needs that you want. But I think the ones it comes with are the standard are almost your go-to anyhow, aren't they?
They are, and I've just realised that. See, the back box on the junction box
is exactly the same as the socket, is it?
Yeah, it's the same as the socket. So that is a, if you look at that there, so.
Good idea.
That's a good, yeah. So we think this is, a great range of outdoor switch and sockets, all IP66, pretty robust, but what do you think?
Yeah, just leave those comments below. We'll leave some links to some of the other videos as well in the description if you want to check those out, and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.